Part 8, types of functions. There is an 4 type of function. First one is an 1-to-1 function. Second one is an many-to-1 function. Third one is an onto function. And fourth one is an into functions. So very first we will see 1-to-1 functions. The another name for 1-to-1 function is an injective function. So if I want to say any function as a 1-to-1 function, then the element which are presented in A must be a distinct element. So what is the distinct element? Distinct element means each and every element which are presented in A should be different. So then the element, distinct element in A have the distinct images of B. So what is the distinct images? Distinct images means the element which are presented in B also different element. So that is A1 is mapped to B1. So that can be written as f of A1 equal to B1. Then A2 is mapped to B3. So that can be written as f of A2 equal to B3. Then A3 is mapped to B2. That can be written as f of A3 equal to B2. And A4 is mapped to B4. That can be written as f of A4 equal to B4. So that is here the element which are presented here are different. A1, A2, A3, A4. So the distinct element which are presented in A have the element which are presented in B are also different. B1, B3, B2. So the it should be mapped to the distinct element which are presented in B. That is the images which are presented in B. So that is called as a 1-to-1 function. Next one is an many-to-one functions. So a function is said to be many-to-one functions. When it is said to be many-to-one function, if two or more elements in A have same images in B. So see the figure here, A1 has the image B1 and then A2 is also have the image B1. So that is the two element in A have the same images in B. So it is called as a many-to-one functions. So that is f of A1 equal to B1 and f of A2 equal to B1. So they both are having the same images B1. Then f of A3 equal to B3. So this type of function is called as the many-to-one function. So next one is an onto function. So the another name for the onto function is an surjective function. So what is an onto function? Consider the two set. One is an set A, another one is an set B. So whenever I say the function f is the onto function, means that the images presented in A should have the pre-image in set A. So for example, if B1 is the image in set B, this B1 will have the pre-image in set A as A2. Okay, the image B2 in set B will have the pre-images as A3. Then image B3 in set B will have the pre-images A1. And then B4, the image in set B will have the pre-images A2. Then B5 will have the pre-images A4. So this is called as the onto functions. Otherwise, we can say the range equal to codomain. What is the range? The corresponding output of the set A, that is called as the range. So what is the for the element A1, what is the output? B3 is the output. So next, for the element B2, A2, what is the output? B4 is the output and B1 is also an output. Then for the element A3, what is the output? B2 is the output. For the element A4, what is the output? B5 is the output. So then what is the range? The range is the B1, B2, B3, B4 and B5. So what is the codomain? The element which are presented in the set B, all the elements are called as the codomain. So here the range and the codomain are equal, so that the function a to b is called as a onto function. Next one is an into function. So what is an into function? Any function is said to be an into function. So if at least one element in B which is not have the image of any element of B. So for example, consider this is the element, this is the set A and this one is the set B. So what is given here? At least one element in B which is not the image of any element in A. So here B2 is the element which are presented in B which does not be the image of any element which are presented in A. Okay, so that only this function is called as the into function. So what is the another one point, main point given here? Range of F is a proper set of the codomain of F. So what is the range? So range means the output of element which are presented in A. So that is the range. So what are the output we are having here? We are having the output as B1, B3, B4 and B5. So the range can be written as B1, B3, B4, B5. What is the codomain? The number of elements, the elements which are presented in B, that are called as the codomain. So what are the elements presented in B? B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. So now compare codomain and range. So the range codomain is also having B1, range is also having B1. So the range B3 and the codomain also having B3, then range B4 codomain is also having B4, range B5 codomain is also having B5. But in codomain we are having one extra element, that is the B2. That means which is the subset? Now range is the subset, but it is the proper subset. Why it is called as a proper subset? Whatever the element which are presented in the range, that should be presented in the codomain. So that only the range of F is a proper subset of the codomain of F. Next one is a horizontal line test. So what is the horizontal line test? If we draw any horizontal line, so horizontal line means a line which is draw parallel to the x-axis. So if the horizontal line intersect the curve at most one point, then the graph represent the one-to-one functions. So that is called as the horizontal line test. So here I am drawing one horizontal line which is parallel to x-axis. So this line intersect the curve at 2 points, so that it is not the one-to-one functions. So now again take the another graph. Here I am drawing one horizontal line, it intersect the curve at the 1 point. That means this graph is a one-to-one functions. So any graph which is one, if I want to test the given graph is a one-to-one or not, then we have to use which test? Horizontal line test.